Go ahead, guys. We got Tatum here.
Hey Tatum, congratulations.
Appreciate it. How you doing?
Doing well. I know that you visited here a couple of weeks ago. Did you get a good sense from that visit that the 49ers might be calling you today?
I actually did. Me and Coach Holland, we hit it off like we knew each other for years when I went up there. Our conversations were just about everything on and off the field. So just me having that, building that relationship that fast with him, I felt a good feeling from that point on.
You're joining fellow teammate Renardo Green out here. What can you tell us about him?
Yeah, Renardo Green is a dog. He actually the one who I feed off his energy, and sometimes he feed off mine. So it's a great feeling to have one of my old teammates back as my teammate again. So
It seems that it's been 3 or 4 years now that the 49ers have been known to have the best linebackers in the NFL. Is that what college linebackers recognize? Do you guys watch film of Warner and Greenlaw and kind of as an example?
yeah, actually, the guy who I actually watched this past season was Greenlaw, because the way he's just show his the way his passion on the field, and he's always around the ball, and his physicality, it reminded me a lot of myself. So yeah, I'm pretty sure the whole college football world knows about the linebacker core at 49ers.
Tatum, both Kyle Shanahan and John Lynch said it was an emotional call in speaking with you. What were your emotions, in the moments after you got drafted?
My emotions were everywhere. I'm not gonna lie to you. It's just waiting that long. I never waited that long in my life, and especially to get picked for something. So just hearing that call and hearing them say they were going to draft me, it just was a dream come true. This is something I always knew I wanted to do since a little kid, and now it happened. Now I'm just ready to work.
At that point in the draft, obviously, I'm sure it's running through your mind, maybe I won't get drafted. Was there a lot of anxiety about that at that point?
Yeah, I was actually on the call with the team speaking about free agent contracts and terms like that before it ended. And in the middle of that call, I got a call. So I got that call. So it was a good feeling.
I hope you hung up on that team immediately.
Yeah, I did.
No, I was like following up on that. Yeah.
What were your conversations with Johnny Holland like? You said you felt like you knew him a long time, but what did those conversations include?
The conversations was literally about everything. Just like sometimes we'll talk about animals, and then we'll go back to talking about football. He was just finding out the things that I was interested in, just like fishing. So I'll tell him a lot of stuff that I would like to do during fishing while I was in Miami and Tallahassee. It's really like we was having a regular conversation. It was nothing specific.
Watching some of your tape, I think you're really good at sniffing out screens, screen passes, making those tackles. Does that come from like film study beforehand? How do you think you developed that particular skill set?
The preparation before the game, and that always plays a big part of how I play. So film study for sure, and it's just being able to have those instincts of just feeling the lineman, to letting guys go and watching my eyes on the running back and see how he releases from the backfield and just give it all away. So it's honestly just instincts and my just preparation before it.
Renardo said he was really excited to join the 49ers because of the aggressive style of defense that they play. Are you familiar with that? And obviously the same mentality as he has.
Yeah, I'm very familiar with it. Just like I said, Greenlaw, he sets the tone for all the physicality to that defense. And then this is adding me and Renardo, I just feel like that's just more fuel to the fire.
Tatum, as far as Renardo, that John and Kyle said, you said like 15 times. He told them he was a dog. You just said he was a dog. He told us at least 15 times he was a dog. I mean, he as a quarterback, those guys aren't necessarily always known, as the most dogged, guys on the field. Is he unique in that sense?
Yeah, I feel like that's what makes him separate. I feel like that's what separates him from all the other corners this past draft. Ronaldo, he likes to come up and tackle, and he'll go play man all game if he has to. So I feel like it's really the mindset that he comes in with every game, and he's very consistent with it.
Yeah, the reverse of that is a linebacker having to cover, and the 49ers ask their linebackers to do a lot of coverage. I think that's one of the strengths of your game, but have the defensive backs like Renardo on your team, have you worked with them just for coverage pointers? How does that work at Florida State?
Yeah, I feel like that's what helped my coverage skills this past season excel how it did. It's just after practice, I'll get releases like I was at corner sometimes, just working on moving my feet and staying on the hip. So just being around the DBs played a huge part. You know, the NFL now is becoming a passing league more and more each year. So just being able to run and be able to stop the run, that would be good for me.
All right, you guys.
Awesome. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thanks, Peter.